Hi friends, here I am going to explain about three topics. The first one is projection of a particle in a circular motion. Second one is composition of a 2HSM in a same period. Third one is resultant motion of a HSM in a perpendicular line is along in a ellipse. In the first topic, we have to show that the motion of a particle A's projection is a simple harmonic. First, we consider AA dash is a diameter. Then draw a perpendicular line via center AA dash. It is denoted O or origin. If A is a particle, then O is a fixed point. Then the motion of a particle A is circle. Here we consider P is a particle A at time t. Then the length is A, that is radius. Angle between AOP is theta. The projection of P on AA dash is Q. The distance between OQ is X. P dash is similar to Q. We are well known here 0 is a center of circle, A is a radius of circle, then AA dash is a diameter of circle. Then P is a position of a particle A at time t. Then Q is a projection of P on AA dash. Theta is nothing but AQ, AOP. Omega is angular velocity. Theta of P about origin, which is a constant. Then distance of Q, the projection of P from origin B, X. We are well known that displacement is nothing but X. That is equal to OQ, that is A cos theta. Then take a derivative, we get minus A sin theta d theta by dt. Then we get minus A sin theta omega. We take second derivative for this. Then we get minus A omega cos theta d theta by dt. Then minus A omega square cos theta. We are well known X is nothing but A cos theta. Then we substitute. We get minus omega square x. Q along the diameter is HSM. Amplitude is nothing but A. Period of oscillation is 2 pi by omega. Initially, P commands its uniform motion when theta is epsilon. At time t, the theta is omega t plus epsilon. Therefore, at time, the displacement is nothing but x is equal to A cos omega t. T plus epsilon. For the motion of a projection P on AA dash is simple harmonic motion. Then we go to the second topic, that is composition of a 2HSM in a same period. Let me take the displacement of two given motion. For first motion, x1 equal to a1 cos nt plus epsilon 1. The second motion, x2 equal to a2 cos nt plus epsilon 2. Therefore, the resultant displacement x equal to x1 plus x2. We substitute x1 value here, that is a1 cos nt plus epsilon 1 plus a2 cos nt plus epsilon 2. It is in the form of cos a plus b formula. Then we substitute cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Then we take common cos nt. Then there are a1 cos epsilon 1 plus a2 cos epsilon 2 minus a1 sin epsilon 1 plus a2 sin epsilon 2. Instead of that, we take a cos epsilon. For that, a sin epsilon. Then it is also in the form of cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Therefore, we apply here the cos a cos b formula, that is we get a cos epsilon plus nt, where a cos epsilon is nothing but a1 cos epsilon 1 plus a2 cos epsilon 2, that is equation number 2. Then a sin epsilon is nothing but a1 sin epsilon 1 plus a2 sin epsilon 2. Then we divide up 1 by 2, that is sin by cos, that is tan inverse equal to a1 sin epsilon 1 plus a2 sin epsilon 2 divided by a1 cos epsilon 1 plus a2 cos epsilon 2. Here the amplitude is a, epoch is epsilon resultant motion is also hsm with the same period as the compulsion motion. From this we are well known the compulsion of a to hsm is a hsm. Next we have to show that the resultant motion of two hsm of the same period along two perpendicular lines is along an ellipse. We are well known the motion of lines as the x and y axis at the time t is: the first particle have the displacement a cos nt, the second particle have the displacement y equal to b cos nt plus epsilon. The second particle have y equal to b cos nt plus epsilon. It is in the form of cos a plus b. So we just expand cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. From the first particle displacement we get cos nt equal to x by a. Then sin square nt equal to 1 minus cos square nt. We substitute cos nt value here. Then 1 minus x squared by a square. We have sin nt equal to 1 minus root of x squared by a square. Then we substitute the cos nt value and the sin nt value in the second particle displacement. Then we get y equal to b into x by a cos epsilon plus or minus 1 minus root of x square by a square sin epsilon. We just squaring on both sides. Then we get y by b minus x by a cos x epsilon whole square equal to 1 minus x square by a square sin square epsilon. The square root is cancelled for the squaring. Then we apply a minus b whole square formula here. Then it is simplified to the x square by a square minus 2 cos epsilon x by xy by ab plus y square by b square equal to sin square epsilon. This is ellipse since the equation satisfies x square minus ab less than 0. Therefore, from this we have well known the resultant motion of two hsm of same period along two perpendicular lines is along an ellipse. Okay friends, thank you.